Warning. This guide has the main purpose of making you laugh, and potentially teach a thing or two. Therefore, it contains edgy memes, a lot of birds, too much liberty, and sarcasm against obese persons. Sorry. A-20, Fat Havoc is an American light bomber, night fighter and ground attacker, used during World War II by France, Great Britain, Australia, and Soviet Union. In War Thunder, A-20 sits on 2.7 or 3.0 in Tier 2, just after the mighty Apache.
Oh my god, that was badass!
To play nicely the Confederate 25, you first have to farm the upgrade modules by killing dumb AI bombers in whale mode, or barracking the dreams of 10-year-old Russian kids in arcade battles who think playing War Thunder is easy like Roblox. Killing a lot of AI bombers commies involve that you go behind them and wash their shitty political ideas with your 6 big 50 caliber machine guns, or simply get under them to let your gunners do the job for you. As the best is to do both. Be careful though, as if you get too close, may an unwanted fire can appear on one of your wing, turning the plane into fastest fidget spinner of all times. So you take distances, or rush in full balls deep mode, after praying RNG, to not catch fire. To spread your vision of Republican democracy in arcade, you found a target, preferably a base with nobody around, and start climbing in the beginning of the battle. When you arrive at your threat, dive on the enemy like a real American bald eagle hunting a Mexican deer, and drop your 4 alawakba stones. When the base is destroyed, go found another one, and repeat until glorious victory. If you bump into an enemy from a dictatorship that is trying to kill you, don't do any sorts of dogfights.
No!
Because turning this plane is harder than a fucking wheelchair, right by an obese American in a McDonald's. Instead, you shoot him in the face and go back to the bombing tactics. Be advised that if you get a
hole in your right wing,
that fucking fat of a plane become hardly controllable and scratch to the ground like a sad stone. Let's talk briefly about landing and takeoff. It's very easy to land the Havoc, since it got a glorious tree cycle landing gear, but the best and faster way remain to slide on your engines. For takeoff it's even easier. I don't really know why I'm losing my time with that. So, we move on to weaponry, which is composed of 6 glorious Second Amendment 12.7mm Browning M2 machine guns, which can send 3 kilograms of liberty per second. You also get defensive 50 cals, 2 in the up turret, and 1 in the bottom of the plane. Sadly, the 6 nose machine guns gets belts with only AP rounds, while the turret's MG get AP incendiary, which mean that you can't burn those freedom hating faggots when you attack them from above like an American symbol. This is why you should keep the default belts in your nose MG, and take universal loadout for the defensives, because you need as much napalm as you can. You also get 4 Big Mac 500 pound bomb or 12 M8 MLG rockets, more on that later. To master ace your plane, research new belts and radiators in the first place, then, new MG, MLG rockets, new turrets and turrets belts. After that research all the extra efficiency modules for more destruction and oil stealing in Arabic countries that shall not be named. To get the best crew of the entire war, you must upgrade G tolerance and stamina on both gunners and pilot, because 700 km/h in dive mode. Then, upgrade vitality, fire precision and accuracy, to make them look like some fucking terminators. After this, upgrade repair and reload speed for logistical services, because you really want your 4,500 pound Big Mac to be delivered faster. I hope that you will never use rockets on bases like the dump scrub I am, and if you do, Please uninstall War Thunder and go play a fucking shit game like World of Crows. You take rockets only in a match with low armored vehicles. To delete your political troubles, you aim at the moving problem and throw liberty at it. It is recommended that you shoot two rockets for one target, because poor accuracy and
explosions!
If you'd like to man fight peoples, you should take the MLG rockets, because you are more agile with it than with the 500 pounds Big Macs that make your plane even more fat. But I shall repeat, rushing peoples in the beginning isn't a good idea, as if everyone spawn in a fighter you will feel the taste of defeat. Just like in Vietnam. You should always destroy bases and avoid meeting Sunday Ray fighters. By retreating far away or to another base, you attack enemies only when they are above their bases or when they charge at you face to face to show them the power of your 50 cals. This is how you play the old brother of the mighty A26 Invaders. If you liked this video, slap that like button, and if you haven't by now, torture your friends like the FBI to make them subscribe. Thank for watching. Thank you.